Welcome back. In this video, we are going to solve example 3.2 that is taken from chapter number 3, Mechanical Properties of Materials, and book name is Mechanics of Material by R.C. Hibbeler, 9th edition. So statement is the stress strain diagram for an aluminum alloy that is used for making aircraft parts is shown in figure 3-19. If specimen of this material is stressed up to 600 megapascal, determine the permanent strain that remains in the specimen when the load is released. Also find the modulus of resilience both before and after the load application. So you can see this is the stress strain graph for this aluminum alloy, and a load of 600 newton is applied. So when it has been asked that when this 600 load is removed from the material, find the permanent set or the permanent deformation in this part. Also find the resilience for both before and after the application of load. So let's start with the solution. So first we will find permanent set. So when the subject is subjected to the load, you can see the load is applied when you increase the load to 600. So the strain, it will strain harden until the point B is reached on the stress strain diagram. Now, what if you remove this 600 load, it will not come to the original point because it has crossed the yield point. So what we will do is that it will, from point B, if you draw a line parallel to this line OA, so it will go down to the point C. Now you can see this line BC and OA, they are parallel, so they are having same slope, and slope of this line will be the modulus of elasticity, and we can find this modulus of elasticity E for line OA. This modulus of elasticity can be found by stress over strain. So stress at point OA is 450. So I can write stress is 450 megapascal, and strain is equal to, you can see this is 0.006, and that is millimeter per millimeter. Clear? So just plug in the value. So 450 megapascal divided by 0.006 millimeter per millimeter will give you the modulus of elasticity E will be equal to 75 gigapascal. So since both line have the same slope, so line BC will also have the same modulus of elasticity. So what we are going to find out, we are going to find out the permanent set, because when you release load of 600 newton at point A, it will go down to this point C. So this will be, this amount of the strain will be there, and this is the permanent strain, and we call this strain is strain OC. Now the total strain till the point of B, or the relative to a load of 600, the strain is 0.203. clear? And we are going to find out this will be our permanent strain. Clear? So our permanent set, so we can write from triangle CBD, we require this CD. Clear? And we can also write that E will be equal to, E for this will be equal to stress. Stress is 600 and strain is this one. Clear? Which is CD, which is not known. So I can write it will be equal to BD divided by CD. So from here we are interested to find out CD. So CD is equal to BD divided by E. Now BD is equal to how much? BD is 600 megapascal divided by E of E is 75 gigapascal. So I can write 75 into 10 raised to power 9 pascal, and you can also write this in pascal, 10 raised to power 6 pascal divided by 75 into 10 raised to power 9 pascal. That will give you CD. Okay, so when you calculate, you will get this CD comes out to be 0.008 millimeter per millimeter. What does this CD means? That when you remove this load of 600, so at this point the strain was 0.023, and when you remove this 600 load, so instead of going to zero, it will go to this point C. It means that this CD or this much of strain is recovered elastic strain. So we can write it as recovered elastic strain, while this strain will be in permanently available in the material. So this is also known as permanent set. So I can write this CD is equal to recovered elastic strain. Now the strain, this strain represents the amount of recovered elastic strain. So the permanent strain will be equal to this total strain, which is 0.0. This is the total strain. So this will be 0.023 minus, if you remove this recovered strain, which is CD, and that is equal to 0.008. Clear? So we will get 0.0150 millimeter per millimeter. And this permanent strain, which we call this epsilon OC, is the permanent strain that will be remain in this material even when you remove 600 mega Pascal load from the material. So this is the answer of our this first part. Now in second part, we have been asked also find the modulus of resilience before and after the application of load. So what we will do is that also you can say that if I will write it over here, note, if gauge marks on the specimen were originally 50 millimeter apart, then after the load is released, the marks will be 50 millimeter plus 0.0150 times 50 millimeters, which means that the marks will be 50.75 millimeter apart. What does it mean? That for example, if this is the specimen and there are 2 point marks on it having a distance of 50 millimeter, and when you apply a tensile load of 600 megapascal, so definitely the length of these 2 points will increase. For example, it will comes to a new point, to this point. So when you remove this load, for example, this is the new length, which is anything here. When you remove this load, so it will not go back, this point, new point will not go back to its original position. Instead, it will go somewhere there. Clear? So this is the original length, and this much is the strain is produced in it. And this strain will be equal to 0.0150, or change in length will be 0.150 multiplied by 50. And that will be 0.75 millimeter. So after the removal of load, this point will still away from this original point. So it will be now at a distance of 50.75 millimeter apart. Now our second part was for modulus of resilience. So before and after, so I will find this modulus of resilience. So modulus of resilience is represented at small r. For initial, it will be equal to 1 over 2 stress for proportional limit into strain of proportional limit. So 1 over 2 for initial, it is equal to, you can see this is 450 and strain is 0.06. So I can write 450 megapascal multiply by 0.006 millimeter per millimeter. So when you solve this, you will get this modulus of resilience initial comes out to be 1.35 megajoule per cubic meter. Now this is the amount of strain energy per unit volume absorbed till the proportional limit for the initial loading. Now for the final loading, when this loading reaches to a load of 600 clear, so we will find the modulus of resilience for final load. So that will be equal to 1 over 2, stress will be 600 megapascal clear, and the strain at 600 megapascal is 0.008 millimeter per millimeter. Let me show you. Here you can see the stress is 600 megapascal, and here we have the strain, or area under this stress strain curve is, this strain is 0.008 that we have calculated over here. You can see this is the strain under the stress strain curve. Okay, so we can write it will be equal to 2.40 megajoule per cubic meter. So I can write it, resilience for final is equal to 2.40 megajoule per cubic meter. Now what does this means? So we will, I do not have the space here to write, but we can see that by comparing these two modulus of resilience, we can say that effect of strain hardening the material has caused an increase in the modulus of resilience. So from this graph, you can also conclude that area under this graph will give you the modulus of resilience, and area under this graph will also give you the modulus of resilience. So in this case, the modulus of resilience has been increased. But on other hand, you can see if you take this graph, so this area under the stress strain graph will give you the modulus of toughness, clear? And for this graph, the modulus of toughness is this one. Now, when you remove this load, so you can see when you remove this load, so the modulus of toughness is going to decrease for this load. So before applying this 600 load, the modulus of toughness was this one. And when you applied this load and you remove this, so modulus of toughness is now decreased. So one thing is that modulus of resilience is increasing and modulus of toughness is decreasing. And that was all about this example 3-2. I hope you have enjoyed this video and you have learned from it. Those who are new to my channel, then subscribe it and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can get notification about my latest videos. If you have any question, you can ask me in comment section. Thank you for watching.